Alright, what's up YouTube? We're back with some more Mono Red action. We're just gonna jump back into it. I love this deck. This deck has been just... This deck and like the blue-black mid-range deck have been the decks that have... The decks that have so impressed me the most since Dominaria came out. So I'm gonna keep playing them here. I'm gonna try this one now. Clean off my glasses. It's been a while since I've used them. Should have used them today. My eyes are kind of sore. I do think that for a little while it's going to be Chain Whirler, the format of Standard, because it kind of fixes its problems. I'm going to mulligan this. Not aggressive enough. His hand's hardly any better, but on six we will give it a shot. Looking for like a two drop on top. Drop would be great. Nope, we don't need a land. Hopefully we just smoke a land or elf here. Oh, we're gonna get smoke a land or elf. Yeah, we are. Alright, Bomat's on time. Man, Moto is already tweaking out on me. Doing the internet, this Moto is losing its mind. Green, white, okay. Probably gonna let that one go. I could also just chain it away, but I think I can get a little more out of the chain gang here. If my opponent wants to trade, they want to trade, but against this green-white deck, I would assume that maybe they won't want to. I could get a little more out of the chain gang here. Opponent's got 5 mana, so they probably have big things to get to. 5 cards in hand. Oh, they do trade, okay. Alright, we will take it. Maybe I'm supposed to chain there, but I think I'm, like, on a mulligan, I think I need to get more out of it. The more I think about it, I think I was actually supposed to, chain there, because I might not even use my mana. Yeah, I was definitely supposed to chain gang there. Well, now I'm not going to, because chain gang plus soul scar mage is a combo. Now I can, like, hit this Heart of Kieran with this lightning strike if I need to. No, don't place for my opponent. Okay. So maybe they shouldn't have traded their elf off. Here. They probably, here comes like a seal away probably. Man, Moto is already tweaking out. Gotta be worried about a Dawnbringer for my opponent. That would be kind of scary. Wow, nothing for them again. Okay. It's nice that we have the Soul Scar Mage there so we can give another play. We even get their first block turned off. Nice. So it gets big dopey green white deck. I think I want to cut. I like cutting these cards because a lot of the time they bring in like cards that fight Graveyard and Kari's Edge just not very high impact. I want everything that kills big things. And I probably, like, Shock is okay. I probably don't need all of them, though. Lightning Strike's, like, decent. I kind of want some of Braids to bring in because they could easily have Aether Sphere Harvester. We saw Heart of Kieran. So I think I'm going to cut, go like this. We still have four ways to answer Land of War Elf on turn one. Actually, we probably can just cut these Shocks also for Magma Sprays because they probably play, like, Resilient Kenra. But we can cut this the last Earthshaker Kenra too. And then get one more Shock in here. I'm gonna leave the land out, bring the land in if I'm on the play. If on the draw, I'm gonna see one more card. Ching, ching, ching. The Chain Gang. It's starting to get dark and gloomy here in Washington, D.C. Yep, we'll keep this. No answer to a turn one elf. But you can't have it all. The Aether Hubs. So it's like a three color deck. Alright, we're just gonna crash in here with this Bowmat Courier. If my opponent wants to trade with it, then we're all about it. We just need to slow this thing down. Yeah, I really have to restart Moto in between next round. Because this is slower than Frozen Ketchup. All right, so we're still... We're gonna get in here. The fact that my opponent didn't attack with this probably means they want to trade this off. And I'm actually okay doing that. I'd like to slow them down. Lifelinking Vampire is cute. Yep, okay, this is fine. This cuts them off green mana. Heart from Kieran. Something to do. Okay. Probably just gonna kill this. Make them, like, find a three power creature. Next turn I'll play a land plus the Chandra. I could make mana with it to try and empty my hand for Hazoret quicker. This is kind of an unfortunate draw for my opponent. Wow, man, we... But that seems kind of loose. I don't think we're going to cast that. Just get this next Chandra. Just get this, the Hazoret down. We're gonna definitely be able to activate it next turn, because worst comes to worst, I'm gonna play a land, pitch two cards. It's been a real tough draw from our opponent. Yeah. That sucks. That sucks for our opponent. Alright, I'm gonna just restart Modo. Sorry about that, everybody. While we're here, you guys can check out the sponsorship, Card Hoarder. They are the best bot chain around. You should check them out. For all your Magic Online needs, they do a great deal for the community, and they're just a really, really important aspect of it, in my opinion. So, they just do great stuff for the game. Gamer Craze is where I learned to play Magic. Their Crystal Commerce is linked below. Feel free, please, if you want some support me further than just the Twitch follow, please check out my YouTube page. I archive all of my streams there. It's the best place to find me. There's lots of Death Shadow content on there. There's been a lot of standard. I put up 3 videos today, put up 4 videos over the week. Lots of Dominaria standard. All the mistakes and all. And if you guys want to interact with me, check me out on Twitter. So, I appreciate y'all, all of you guys for being here. Here in just a second. Man, my puppy bit my thumb today. Like, he was trying to bite his toy, and I was like pulling it with him, and he went to like re-grip, and he got my thumb, and oh my god, that hurt. Like, I've got, like, he got in there deep. Slow train today. Running that plenty of bits with the stream. Oh, there we go. All right, we are back in business. Put it back on the stream. Let's get our lead going on here. We're fifth of the way there to the old 5-0 dream. I'm gonna go grab a glass of water while this is loading up here. Because I have Super Saiyan Hazards. Alright, would like to play first. Saiyan's pretty good. Keep this. Hope my opponent wasn't intended on blocking. A tough time with this deck, but we got a Chain Gang, so that should be pretty good. Hopefully we can milk it a little bit in order to get more creatures. Oh, we're playing against Mario Vehicles. All right, so now we're just gonna take the twofer. Get out of my face. Man, this card is so good. God, this thing is busted. So that can block. Shock this. Next turn, we're going to just come right back at it with another exert creature. This is the nut right here. They just scoop it up. Chain Gang got two creatures, and that was all she wrote. So in this matchup, we want to go big. I want my Magma Spray, my Braids, and the Chandras, and the Glory Bringers, and the PNLRs. I think that they're going to cut, well, so I kind of have to be careful, because I definitely want to cut my Lightning Strikes for the Braids and the Aether Sphere Harvesters. Oncrop Crasher seems kind of medium, because like it's an X2, they're going to have a lot of ways to kill it. PNLR seems pretty great. I don't think that they're going to... I definitely want to cut these shocks. I think they're going to go a little bit bigger, but I don't want to just get caught with my pants down. And cut these Kari Zevs. And then maybe bring in like this. I like a couple Glory Bees. Chandra's Defeat. Then I'll bring in just one more shock. Yeah, I think this is what we're going to do here. I just want to be ready just in case they go big. Like, I don't want to just be caught out with nothing going on. Alright, we'll keep this. Soulscar Mage is pretty good. PNLR is good. Hazoret's. We have Super Saiyan Hazoret. Actually, I'm gonna mulligan. Yeah, this hand's not super great. We'll put Soulscar Mage on the top. It's just something to do. I really like Soulscar Mage. I like how, especially with like the Chang Gang, you know, we now can turn into this like Soulscar Mage control deck. About nothing. Nothing from our opponent. Hopefully our opponents gives us something to smoke next turn with this Chain Gang. Taking a brave trade for that. Now, I wonder if I want to just run this Chain Gang out here. I don't really have anything going on, it's just a bunch of removal. So maybe it's right to just play the creature. Yeah, we're going to get this thing out here. I have so much removal that I'm going to be able to deal with whatever my opponent plays that I've got to get on the battlefield, I think. My opponent can't really do anything without an artifact. All right, we're just going to kill that. Because we don't want them. This turns on their Spire for colored mana. We're just gonna beat for three. I wonder if my opponent's playing Karn. Karn's a card that can help in a situation. I mean, if they get to the lands in time, like Karn can help fix their mana. I use Shock there because Magma Spray can hit Scrap Heap Scrounger. I'm going to hold this land. Because we can still go land Hazoret if we draw it. And we can play the Magma Spray. Land Glorybringer. We can just do like land everything we need to. Alright. Harvester with nothing to crew it is not as good as it could be. So land Hazoret off the top is game. Not quite. I'm gonna play the Scavenger Grounds now because I could cycle. I could have to like ditch a land at some point. And the Scavenger Ground can get like a whatever it is. A Rekindling Phoenix, so I don't really want to discard it. My opponent's playing that. It's kind of been two poor draws, to tell you the truth. Like, I haven't really done a lot. My opponent has done nothing. Should I hit this now? No, that was stupid. I should have waited. Yeah, that was dumb. They're gonna attack? Probably they should attack. It's gonna gain them some life. Oh, Nathan, thank you very much. Alright, so I'm gonna attack first. Don't show them that I have the land. They probably blocked the Chain Whirler because they don't want this to come back. Alright. I'm just gonna hold the land because even if I draw Hazoret, I can go like land Hazoret and get in there. I am running out of stuff to do though. Kind of a lackluster draw for the home team here, which kind of sucks. They have a lot of energy. Oh, because they have two harvesters. Forgot about that. Okay, so what does that do? That just kills them on the dot. Unless they got a Chandra's Defeat, but smoke this Thopter and get in there. Looks like they got the defeat. Are they gonna make sure that I remember to exert? I guess they could have like a Fatal Push or a Magma Spray to hit my Kari Zev with, or to hit this with. Yeah, it looks like. Yeah. All right, put him to 2. That was unfortunate, but what are you gonna do? I guess it's like the net same. This is pending they don't have a play, which probably, this probably means they have a play. Though that was a costly Magma Spray because it took an energy away from them. Our draw has been less than ideal. But at least the Glory Bee is coming off. It's nap next turn. I for they have something for this. Oh, little Murder Blaze. Now what is it? This on defense? God, the mana is just rough in this deck. They could have Settle the Wreckage, but that would hurt them to cast. And I do get to smoke this PNLR, so I think I'm alright if they have we're playing to Settle the Wreckage. Man, we might lose this one. All right, we get this Bomat Courier out there. Bomat's at least a redraw. Plays in to Settle the Wreckage, but like, do what you gotta do. That's not good. All right, Bomat, take me to the promised land. There's the Hazoret. It was the next card down. That's unfortunate. That's so unfortunate. The Magma Spray is a big game from them. Alright, on the play, I think I want a little less. Or on the play, I think Chandra's alright. Probably want a little less removal. I can cut this Shock. Another Magma Spray. I'm assuming they don't have Glorybringers in the draw. So let's go like this. Be a little more aggressive on the play. Get some more of our big heavy hitters in. This hand's great. Let's get some Chain Gang action. And what sucks is like a hand like PNLR used to be just such a good way to stabilize against this deck, and like the Chain Gang just completely stops all of that shenanigans. This is gonna get Magma Sprayed. I'm gonna be sad. That's sad. All right, we're just gonna cast the first one here because we're looking to empty our hand. We want to get the big boy down here. The man, the myth, the legend. We want to play this Hazoret. Just always get the Hazoret down. Hopefully, let's not get Settle the Wreckage this turn. Alright, sweet. We're gonna get the Chain Gang. Wow, they're coming in. That's aggressive. That is super aggressive, I think. Ooh. So now I can go Chandra, make mana, play the Chain Gang, crack in. That sounds like a plan. Make mana. It always feels like super busted whenever you make mana with Chandra for like a really explosive turn. And now next turn I can like minus on the Pia. If they go to crew this, then I can exert the Glorybringer on it, and then they can't block either of these Chain Gangs. What I've got to worry about, though, is I don't want to get Settle the Wreckage out of this game. The fact they're pausing here probably means... It could mean some gamesmanship. Like, they could have it. They could just be thinking. But it's basically the only way that I lose. This Chain Whirler, like, cards that used to be really good against mono red, and like the tokens deck, this Chain Whirler just is, it's like, it's similar to Ferocidon. You know, it kind of invalidates the strategies that are usually very good against mono red decks. In the tank. Hope everyone hanging out is having a good night. Just relaxing here. Maybe they've got a couple plays, they're thinking. Hopefully they're not just like wasting my time, wasting our all of our time here. Give him the test message. See how he's doing. God, my dog chomped my finger so hard today. Like, he was pulling his toy and I was pulling back on it. And then I went towards him and he rebit. And man, he got me like right above the nail and then right at the tip of the finger. And he got me good. Those sharp puppy teeth. Play. All right, Glorybringer. So it doesn't really do anything. It makes it so that I can't kill it if they hit this, which is kind of annoying. The fact that if they attack Chandra, it's actually kind of annoying. I would assume they're gonna attack Chandra, yeah. They're just, now they're dead. Well, they might be dead. They're at 13. Now we exert on this, they need another creature, and then they're dead to a Hazard activation. So go team. God, I love me a Glorybringer. I thought it was nice. Said sorry to step away. Which that happens. Suck it in chat. No, I'm not gonna say suck it, Nate. You're so mean, Nate. Nate, this deck is so good. I wish I would have, like, tasted heard the sweet gospel of Hazoret earlier. It's just so awesome. Like, our Lord and Savior, Super Saiyan Hazoret here. His hand's pretty good. His hand's a pretty explosive hazard hand. That kind of sucks. Now we have two hazards. Block. Please block. Please block. Damn it. Thrashing Brontodon. That's a card that I... just a card I can't beat. We just got a hazard playmat. I might need a hazard playmat. This is so gross. I kind of want to kill this before they can... before my opponent can, like, Blossoming Defense it. So we got Brontodon. Oh, man. Oh, another Jade Light Ranger. So we're gonna keep Rhonas on top. So they're gonna have Rhonas and Brontodon. They didn't keep, that's pretty greedy of them to not keep lands. I guess Rhonas is like an additional blocker. Might as well leave back my BOMAC couriers. They'll probably just eat this. I don't really see how I'm gonna win. And here comes the Brontodon. Oh, there's a Galta. All right, we are dead. We are dead as a doorknob. Big Houston, we have a 12-12. I guess we'll just play this out. Well, we're just super dead because this is trample and he can pump it a million times and we can't block with this. Dead as a doorknob. This mono green deck is tough. Like, these green decks are tough for mono red. I don't think these green decks are very good other places from when I've played them. Like, they're just too slow for, like, the control decks and such. With that artifact deck, Squad Chief. Best deck in the format. Artifact de Djinn. Are you talking about what's his name? From Metagame Gurus? Whatever, we're just gonna make him block. Whatever, we were dead anyways. Are you talking about this guy? There, Squad Chief? You could not pay me. Well, you probably could, but I'm not gonna do that. All right, so we need some ways to kill X4s and bigger creatures. So we're gonna bring in some of the bigger guys. I'm gonna cut some of my shocks on the play because they don't really do a lot besides kill Llanowar Elf. We don't need any of this Karizev shenanigans. Pia's probably okay because it can make some things not block. I should cut some lightning strikes, bring some abrades in because they're definitely going to have ways to deal with this. Oliver Hart. Yeah, that's the guy from the Metagame Gurus. It doesn't seem to work. I know, I owe you $12, Nathan. The Pillow Pilot deck was just, it was outside of my loan range. I'm gonna have to sideboard kind of differently on the draw because I'm gonna need some way to interact with Llanowar Elf or I'm just gonna get run over. White black approach. I played against an approach deck today. Or not an approach deck. I played against a Lich's Mastery deck today. Twas not super great. Looked a little anemic. Approach, gain 7, draw 7. Dude, I love Magical Christmas Land. Squad Chief, what'd you play? I saw that, because that's Andrew Jessup, Oliver Hart. I saw that he was playing Mono Red for a little while, and then he got a God Pharaoh's gift deck that was posted. Keep this. This could easily go wrong. We're gonna play Soulscar Mage on 1. And then go double Bowmat on 2. Oh man, no elf. That's sweet. We're not gonna draw land next turn, and then I'm gonna throw up. Throw up. I guess it's just get in for damage. Oh, is that the mistake that I still haven't fixed yet? Shows my intelligence. Yeah, I'm just gonna play this Kenra, get in for damage. Like they're probably gonna play like a Jade Light Ranger next turn that this Kenra won't hit. Oh, that's the end today. What are we gonna do? They're gonna bounce one of my creatures? What is this? Unsummon. They unsummon my Kenra. That thing's big. Oh, nice, because this Soulscar Mage, we're actually going to be able to deal with this thing. We assume he's going to block something. We still get 2-for-1, but we gotta deal with this huge thing. It's gonna be unfortunate if we just die here not having drawn lands. Just draw 2 lands. Draw 2 lands, damn it. They ditched it, and they ditched the land one else. And now we'll pass. At least we can attack in the air now. The cute little Thopter. Uh-oh. So, I could just dump my hand, make it so this can't block. Attack with this as well. My opponent probably, like, eats. I could just dump my hand, make it so this can't block, and then my opponent probably blocks here, takes 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The next turn I play Hazoret. Yeah, I think that's the plan. I think we're just going all in here. If they want to trade here, that's fine. They trade here, then 2. I get him for a lot of damage. Now the Hazoret's lethal next turn. Uh-oh. That's so bad. My opponent just gained 42 life, and the thing's huge. All right, well, we're just gonna start slamming in with Hazoret. I probably can attack with the Kenra too, because I don't really care if he blocks the Kenra. I should turn off my auto yield so I can play a land. So that if I top deck a land, I can bring the Kenra back at least. A new card that would be absolutely insane here would be the Chain Gang. Chain Gang would be great because it would just like kill the Soul Scar Mage. It would just shrink everything. You gotta block this Hazoret, right, dude? Must have some more explore cards. But we can throw this artifact at this Wildgrowth Wanderer if we need to like push through it. Alright, more explore. Just draw cards. No. I just gain 1,000,000 life. Oh, this game's gonna get so much harder. He's just gonna explore 40 million times. This has been unfortunate. I'm just going to attack for 3 in the air and then play a Soul Scar Mage and just pass. Oh, this is so unfortunate. We were so close. I don't think we're ever going to beat this thing. Maybe my opponent will just draw lands for the rest of the game. You never know. Yeah, that's. I think this is going to be a bit too much to overcome. Because you can just, like, eat this. Yeah. What was I supposed to do? I mean, I'd have to look back more, Nathan. Because, like, I put him in a position where he had to chump the Hazoret, or he was dead. But then this Wild Growth Walker just, like, murked me. Yeah, let's just concede here. They got this. I want to look back at this now. And see if I toss this game here. View replay. Okay, so... what do we got here? Oh, God. Now it goes. Now we're at my turn. Okay, so we played Bomats and we attacked. My opponent does their turn. We play another Bomat. Are they? This is when they unsummon the Kenra. Steel Leaf Champion. So we had to do this, right? We had to. This isn't what you're talking about. So we go the next turn, pass through this turn, they explore. So that's a turn we just played Pia and didn't do anything. What we need is we needed lands 3 and 4 on time, but that's part of our keep, I guess. I feel pretty good here. Okay, so there's the Wild Growth Wanderer. Okay, so are you talking right here? Is this what you're talking about, Nathan? When I hit here... play this Bomat Courier and tossed it. And then attacked right here. So my line of thinking here was like, so they trade here, we put them down to 2, 2, 5 gets through, right? 2, 4, 5, 6 gets through, they go to 5, and then they have to chump the Hazoret. This is gonna be such crap viewing for my YouTube channel. Cause this makes it so like they have to chump the like my whole game plan is they have to chump Hazoret here. They're just in the abyss for the rest of the game. If they don't have anything. And like I didn't wanna wait, because the longer we play against this card, the worse it gets, right? And then like it all kind of fell apart here because they play the Jade Light Ranger, and they go to 11. And what'd I do here? I swung in with Hazoret, right? Yes, but Nathan, what else am I doing? Like, are you saying that I should have attacked with the... You're saying that I should have attacked with the Bomat Courier? We're gonna start the next round. Are you saying that I should have attacked with the Bomat Courier and discarded my Hazoret? Or not done anything with the Bomat Courier? Because I think that your line of play says just sit there, right? And not do anything? Against a Wild Growth Walker with 3 cards in hand. Just lead back the bone. Oh, you're saying attack with everything else and put them to 6. Okay, I guess I see that, because it's the same thing, right? Because they have to chump the Hazoret next turn, right? They still have to chump Hazoret, because even if they're at 6, a hazard activation kills them. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I tossed that. Yep, that was my fault. Yep, that's my fault. Yeah, I should have waited because the hazard was still lethal because of its ability. Oh man, here's John's girl. Alright, we're gonna keep this.
What's going on, bud? How are you?
Probably gonna play Kari Zev on 2. Depending on what they... Let's see what they have here. We're gonna play the mirror. Now I kind of just want to play Bomat. Nah, I'm gonna attack and then play Kari Zev. I want to save this Kenra for when something happens. Or like, nope. I want to play this. I want to save the Kenra for when I can use its ability. Alright, well now we're gonna use one of the Kenras. Now we're gonna get absolutely destroyed by the Chain Gang here. But then we're gonna see why that card is sick. Okay, we're not gonna get Chain Gangs, thank God. Now we're gonna get our Soul Scar Mage down here. I guess this doesn't really matter. And then we'll just like ditch this Bomat Courier if we need to. Always yield. It's so weird that like how impactful this Soul Scar Mage is. Now that, all right. I think we're just gonna wait because they need to block. They need to block two of our creatures. They need to block three of our creatures in order to not die next turn. So all right, we get the mono red mirror. So Onkrop Crashers come out. Lightning Strikes come out. Cards I want to bring in. Harvester comes in. Defeat, Magma Spray, and a Braid come in. PNLR comes in. We're going to shave on some Kenras because of the Chain Gang. I think this is what we're gonna do. We got a bunch of like good removal. We're less weak to the Chain Gang. I don't really like going big in this matchup because of how important Hazoret is, but like Hazoret isn't even as good in these mirrors anymore because of Chain Gang plus Soul Scar Mage. You got all four Whirlers, that's important. Because this card is nuts. Absolutely nuts. Alright, it's a pretty good hand. We have a Soul Scar Mage, which is important. This card's super, super underrated. I didn't realize how good this card was until like I played with it. Opponent Mulligans. Means I get quicker Hazorets. Alright, Bomey Boy. Block. Why no bird? I think that the alright, so I think that's worth a braiding, as sad as that makes me feel. Cause like I just know that I'm gonna get Aethersphere Harvester. The Chain Gang, Nathan. Like, the Chain Gang just invalidates the bird. Like, the chain... Like, the mirror is all about not getting blown out by the Chain Gang and then landing Hazard effectively. Because, like, if we just draw Chain Gang here, the game's over. We didn't do it. I kind of like Soul Scar Mage, Bomac Courier Shock this. Because, like, this is going to be turned on in a second. And now you can, like, you can set up things where you can... Oh, shoot. I clicked on the wrong... I was just clicking too fast. I was talking. Oh, I don't know. See, this doesn't really do a lot. Oh, he kind of does. Kills both of these. I just think that, like the control decks have all been these, like, Seal Away decks. So I think the card's not as good as it used to be. So we're going to actually look to trade the Pia because we drew another one. Like, just hit this Kenra. My opponent's got another chain here. Kind of sucks. Where I do like the bird a lot is against the green decks. Because it flies, goes over the top of them, and then you can just kind of like chump block with it forever. Yeah. Just... And now I think we got a block. Well. I can't do anything against these cards. Yeah, I think we're on the block train. We're gonna block with this Harvester. We're gonna feel so bad if they're sitting on an Abrade. Or a Shock. The nice thing is if our Harvester lives next turn, we can get a 5-point life swing, so we can pump it with Pia. Yeah, now we're in good shape. All right, that's pretty good too. So, crew here. I can attack with both of these, and I can shrink this chain. If they go to double block, I can at least get one chain gang off the battlefield, but then I gotta deal, I got 2-for-1. I think we're gonna play it on, we're gonna use the Soul Scar Mage on defense. We don't get the Pia. Actually, I should have done it with a Thopter because of my another Chain Gang from my opponent. A little 4-point life swing. Oh, here comes a Hazoret. Hell, no Hazoret? Oh my gosh. That's unreal. Rage is so good. Dire Fleet Daredevil. Okay, so now they're gonna raid my Harvester. Alright, now I'm in a little bit of trouble because both their creatures have first strike. Chain Gang. Son of a bitch. So we're gonna double block here. That's the game plan. My opponent's got one more card. I guess I should hold everything back and be prepared to triple block this Dire Fleet Daredevil. They have a Kindling Phoenix. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is, we're getting to the unfortunate part of the game. My opponent mulliganed, but they chain ganked us twice. And I think that's like the big difference. That's just game over. Probably supposed to chump this, but it doesn't really matter anymore. Yeah, we're dead. We're dead. Okay, on the play now. On the play. So my opponent's going big. So I wonder if I should go big to fight that or just try to stay lean. Because like I could cut some shocks. I could cut the rest of my Kenras just so that we don't get, you know, we don't get chain ganged as bad. And then bring like these in. Maybe cut like a Karizev, bring the land in. Let's give this a whirl. Let's give this a whirl. All right, keep this. I'm gonna lead off on Soulscar Mage because the Firebrand can pick off a Bomat Courier if it needs to. Oh, that was stupid. I should have played. I was thinking I was gonna like abrade something because these just stare at each other and don't really do anything. But the last thing that I want to do is abrade anything that's not an Aethersphere Harvester. So this was stupid. This was all just stupid. I'll braid that. Now I'm just gonna attack and then play Pia. Hope we don't get chained. This is a big thing why I don't really like Pia. This is just what like I saw Matt Focals play. I don't really like Pia because Pia is not, oh, Grasping Dunes. Is it like Pia just gets chain ganged? I'm not really interested when that happens. I want to draw Hazoret. Combat the birds. All right, we'll take our twofer. I really don't want to play this Fanatical Firebrand until I use it, but, and I can still go like, I can still go, even if I draw Hazoret, I can go land Hazoret Fanatical Firebrand, because like, wow, they have a lot of Grasping Dunes. They still have Crashers in their deck, okay. Something. Oh man. This has been an unfortunate draw. At least now I can hit this and shrink it. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know, Nathan. Like, I've had some times when it's been okay, sometimes it's not. So we kind of get a little 2-for-1 here, but he's probably going to just going to play a Karizev, okay? We need a chain gang. Bad. God, that's just going to win us the game here. The didn't block. They didn't attack. They must have just clicked through. So now I'll trade with both of these if I get the option to, and then just scavenger grounds away the Kenras. This happen. Firebrand, exert here, take 7. God, we need a chain gang really bad. Come on. Ugh. What do we got? We got one more draw step. This is assuming my opponent misses. All right, we have one more draw step. Come on! All right, that's a redraw. Come on, BOMAC Courier. Make it happen, BOMAC Courier. We have enough to literally... Nope. Yeah, that was just like a super sad draw. There. Oh, there it was. Oh, that was so sad. Yeah, I think, but I don't know, maybe you're supposed to leave the Kenras in, but it's just like, I would love it if I could set up a thing where just I can play around the Chain Gang as much as possible. Alright, we're gonna keep this. Lead on Soulscar Mage and double Bomat on 2. John will be happy at least. That's what we're looking for here. Yeah, they chained us in game 2. They even mulliganed in game 2, and the chain like brought him out of it. Dragon Skull Summon. I have no idea what's going on. Is this like a BOMAC Courier? Get to the point where is this going? It's going in the Kenra, okay. I don't really want to activate one of these until I can activate both of them. Plus, like, we're doing just fine as is. Scrylands are cool. I don't know what decks can play them. Put a card on top. What is this? It's like a Rekindling Phoenix. Oh, that's gross. Okay. I've seen Teferis. They're out of like the blue-white decks. Card's pretty good. So I think I just get rid of both of these. Hold priority. And now we just draw a new hand. Oh my gosh. We didn't even hit land. Oh! I mean, we've got the tools to win, but it's been one of those games. As long as they don't have a way to gain life, we should be able to get them. This has, like, such inevitability. Now we're in trouble. Land. Alright, well at least I can attack. And if they go to block, I can at least like shrink the harvester. To make sure the harvester doesn't do any damage. I think I'm just gonna play Soulscar Mage and Firebrand and hit this Walking Ballista. Just shrink this. This has been very unfortunate for the home team here. I think the control decks are actually pretty good, Nathan. Because, like, cut. We're about to get cut to ribbons. Captain Lannery Storm. You don't say. Like, I think they're pretty good. I think, like, they might struggle a little bit against mono red. But I think they're good against, like, mono green, which is kind of the deck that, like, beats up on the mono red decks. God, well that's actually like the best draw if we're not gonna draw a land. We're supposed to only get one card, but they attack me for six. Like, I'm dead over the span of two turns. And this cut ribbons here is gonna do quite a bit of damage to me. Because this is what? XX. So they can cut for four. So they're gonna put me to six here. And then I can't attack. Oh, they could. Yeah, it sucks the mana doesn't carry over. I'm actually gonna have to start, like, killing creatures next turn. Oh, no, legend, okay. Land. Okay. So, now I think I play the Chain Gang. And then they don't have any good attacks next turn. And then if I draw another land, I just lightning strike them out. I think we're just gonna wait. There's no sense attacking. I don't think. Especially when next turn we can just like make this not block with the Onkrop Crasher and get in there. This game has been much closer than I thought it was going to be after about 10 turns. This is sick. This is where these cards are just so good together. Get some grindy matches of Magic here. The other deck that I've been pretty impressed with is the blue-black deck. Like, the blue-black deck, like the blue-black mid-range deck, I've been impressed with that a lot. I think Cast Down's a pretty good card for that deck. Because, like, Fatal Push is kind of meh. Sometimes it's either really good or it isn't. So they can cut me for 4, and I go to 3. But if they do that, they're just dead. So we're stuck between a rock and a hard place currently. Then revolt, I guess, so maybe this was a mistake. All right, land off the top. Yeah. All right. That was close. That was a lot closer than I thought it was going to be. So against red-black artifact deck, I want to bring in my Abrades, bring in my Magma Sprays, bring in the Pias, because they don't have the chain gang. Bring all this in, cut my Lightning Strikes, the Firebrands are probably fine, we don't need these on-crop crashers, and I cut one card. We'll go submit. I actually stole a Teferi with a Gonti earlier today. We're gonna ship this hand. Shout out to Tyler Cook, tagging me in some Facebook posts there. What a guy. We don't want this, we just want lands. It's not a land. I'm just gonna pass. I don't think I'm gonna play this Soulscar Mage and do whatever wizardry this land is here. Show me a Kari Zev, damn. Now we're just, like, super punished for our actions. Alright, well now we're going to play 2. So it's going to take them 2 removal spells if we draw land. Well, I guess if we draw land, we're talking where the Harvester doesn't have haste. So, not attacking with it right off the bat. Hope your card sorting is going well, Tyler Cook. Mox Amber, here we go. This is a Hazoret. It's a Chandra. That's worse. You're going to go down one of these? We're just going up? Okay. Well, now we're going to attack it with both. I want to do this because if my opponent blocks, then I get to take out the Kari Zev. Just saying, if this was a shock, man, would that have been just... I guess shock wouldn't have done very much different, actually. You open a foil Amber. Nice, Tyler. Tyler, look at you there. You with that Twitch Prime. I see what you got right there. I see it, Tyler Cook. I see you. Making mana, that can't be good. 6 mana, what is this? It's like a legend, the legendary thing. He's got roast both my creatures. Nice. So we're just going to deal 3 damage here. So if my opponent wants to kill this, they have to go down with it, and then I can Kenra at it next turn if I need to. Oh, just making mana for days. Like, it's going out of business. So then I'm going to play a creature to crew my... Okay. They should just be... Yeah. What's my plan? I gotta get this Chandra off the battlefield. Alright, that like kind of does it, then I can jump block the Hazoret. Get this thing. Maybe they have like a million expensive cards in their hand. They can't turn this Hazard on. Oh, this is like a license disintegration. I'm gonna puke. 6. Dead. Yep. They got me. Wasted that much. What do you mean, what am I doing? Confused, Nathan. Did I make a mistake? I did make a mistake earlier. You caught it. You caught me in the act, Nathan. Now that I'm on the play, do I want to change anything? I want to cut some removal, I think. Probably can bring this Kenra back in. Though I'm not in love with it. We'll go with what Nathan said. Can bring in one Chandra on the play. Well, if they have Chandras of their own, I kind of want Glorybringers. I'm gonna cut these shocks. I got firebrands to deal with like X1s that are early in the game. We're gonna bring the dragons. But no reason to chuck the monkey. I was just trying to get the Chandra. I was trying to get Chandra off the battlefield. That was the plan there. Oh my god, we drew the Scavenger Grounds. While we have the Chain Whirler. This is why we sideboard this card. We'll puke. Alright, I'm gonna save the Firebrand until we need it. Drew another Chain Whirler. I think we're just gonna cast this. And it's just attack with everything. I'm not gonna go to shoot this, have this shoot something. I'm not gonna get 2-for-1 here. Just coming in with a T. Things. You talking about last game, Nathan? With the monkey and the whirler. Yep, so that's what he does there. I probably should have played this after combat. Because this has some value with the Soulscar Mage. swear to God, if he chain gangs me, no, he's not going to. Okay, Pia. Oh my God, come on, give me a land. Game's over. Pack it up. My opponent wants to trade with this BOMAC courier. How do I feel about that? We made that mistake last game of just tossing away BOMAC couriers. So maybe we just want to attack with this Soulscar Mage. Nathan, I'm being disciplined here. I really want to send it in and get one more damage in and get this off the battlefield. But I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. My opponent plays like a Chandra, Mox Amber. Okay. What do we got here? This is like a Glorybringer coming into town. Glorybringer's coming to town. Glorybringer's coming to town. Glorybringer is coming to town. Probably exerts on this the Soulscar Mage or the Chain Whirler. Oh my God, he's just Jaya's Inferno me out of this in the next. Yeah. This Jaya's Inferno has not been bad. Yeah. And it's nice that we still have this Soulscar Mage for this Abrade, so we still have, like, outs to... Like, even if my opponent plays a Hazoret, I can still deal with it. Alright, Scrap Heap Scrounger. I think we're just going to serve in here. Braid something here. Probably look to kill him on the next turn. Okay, so let's think here. This could be anything, which could be kind of annoying. So if I abrade this now, I come in, it's 5 on the board. They can block this, they have a removal spell. We still could be in a little bit of trouble. I think we're killing the Kari Zev though. I think that's our plan here. Opponent's F6. God, we can't catch a break. Opponent's got to block here or here. If they block here, they die. Probably trade with the Kenra. But Jaya's Inferno has looked good here, Nathan. You are correct. Land, so if we hit a land next turn, we can bring the Kenra back. The Inferno has looked pretty good in this matchup. The problem is, I don't think this card's very good. Because, like, it's only good, like, in the mid game. And, like, he's playing a deck that I'm not sure should be trying to play into the mid-game. Alright, Ballista buys them a turn as long as unless I draw a land. All right. Let's open up our pity chest. I think I've got time for one more round, one more league.